What's up, you all? And as requested, the baddest background vocal layer I've ever heard in my life, Miss Brandy, rather be a color show. Let's get right on into it. I know them layers is gonna be fire. I just know it.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is dedicated to all the fans out there. I love this song.
I knew it.
So why are you even trying to ignore me? But it's not always looking my attention.
Hey,
just
feel the tone. So warm, I love it.
Baby, yeah. I'd rather be kissing you, baby. I know you feel it.
Come on.
You know I love you down deep within. You're my best friend when we are together. Feels like forever. You're kissing me the way you do. Everybody in this world is like us too. That's why I'd rather.
That's plasma. That's plasma. That's right at the source. I mean, just... I'm speechless. The musical transitions that the song takes itself through. I'm blown away by this whole thing. This is R&B. This is real R&B. This should be on every single R&B station blasting 24/7. I felt everything about it, the beat, again, the musical transitions, that old school sort of sound that came, that was on the very beginning of the song, that old school thing that all them old songs, you know, use that sound. I mean, the song itself is fire, and Brandy came in with them smooth, airy, smoky vocals. And again, I'm sorry, the baddest blends in the business in the background. I mean, just the layer and the blend. Y'all know I know. That to me, she's just, I mean, just the most consistent and just most creative with those backing blends. She's just, every Brandy song, I'm like, these are about the best blends I've ever heard. She just stacked. The lady stays stacked. And my God, just epicness and just her tone naturally. She doesn't got to do much for me. She's one of them singers for me. She don't got to do much. You know, Whitney Houston is one of them for me. Who else? Whitney Houston, Anita Baker, Toni Braxton. Those warm tones, those full tones, and those colorful, just so deep that like and Brandy's one of them. They don't have to do much. She could have sat there and sung in that heavy, airy tone near the beginning of the song for the whole song, and I would have been happy. Just that airy, smoky tone of hers, I mean, I would have been in bliss. I love that tone. And then she brings out that when she did the four-chested belt and then descending run at what maybe around half the song. Just killed that too. Killed the full chest and just the power there. And I said it before, I'll say it again. She's so smoky at times, but when she gets into her full chest belt, it's crystal clear. It's youthful. It's just, it's a completely different thing when she's in her full chest. You know what I mean? She sounds like she's exactly the same as she did in the 90s. She's not, in my opinion, she's not changed. Particularly in that chest, that just the purity and the clarity of the chest and even the power there is, which is, and the run was sickening. I mean, her runs throughout, we know her agility is just, I love her placement though. Especially, I love the placement. I love every ornamentation. I love it. I love it, love it, love it, love it. No complaints here whatsoever, doggone it. And that ending run that she did, I mean, that's why you got this. You don't just do that. You got to listen to that a few times, and it's not just a simple descending run or ascending run. I mean, she went places. She went around the block. You know what I mean? And when the music just was with her on that, I mean, just the dynamic of the music itself. I love it. I love the song. I love her vocals on here. This one I'ma download. After the video, because this joint goes hard. The whole song and the vocals, this is bad. Thank you all for liking and subscribing, and please continue to support your favorites. Peace.